Good morning, everybody. Welcome. This is not the official start, but I just wanted to say a very warm welcome to All Saints on this Easter day and happy Easter. Thank you. It's really good to be able to welcome you wherever you've come from today, whether you're visiting us, whether you're a regular here, wherever you've come from, whatever you bring with you today on your heart and on your mind, your joys and perhaps your sorrows as well. We bring them all into the presence, into the light of the resurrected Lord this morning. We have a number of people watching us at home and joining in our worship in spirit through what we like to call the miracle of YouTube. So I wonder if you wouldn't mind just turning around and looking at the camera at the back and saying Happy Easter to all those who are joining us at home. Happy Easter! You are all very welcome too. Just a bit of housekeeping for those of you who might not be familiar with this building. There is a loo through the wooden doors at the back. Feel free to use it. When we come to communion this morning, communion is going to be distributed here, just in front of the tomb, which will be revealed shortly. Communion will be distributed here. Today we are introducing wine with the bread for the first time in 2 years. And the way we're going to do that is that the wafers will be dipped into the wine by me and handed to you. So as you come forward, if you could have your hands open like that, the wafer will be placed into your hand. It's not going to drip, don't worry. We've practiced this. But if for any reason you don't want to receive the wine, if you'd prefer just to receive a wafer on its own, as you come forward, just say so. We don't need to keep silent or anything, so just say no wine and that will be fine. I can give you a wafer. If you would like to receive a prayer of blessing, that's fine too. Just keep your hands down below and we will pray for you. Mrs. Churchwarden, yes.
We haven't got enough faith because we haven't had enough orders of service and things done, so if people can share, we might need to...
I think there might be some more on the shelf. Yeah, if you haven't got a service booklet, do share them around. If you need one, put your hand in the air. You should have a yellow booklet like this, a green hymn book, and a sheet with the words of the Gloria on it. And the last thing I want to say is some of you may have found some musical instruments around. If you have, they are to use basically whenever you want. I don't set the rules around here, so use your instruments whenever you want. But, oh, thank you, Colin. but especially we're going to use our bells and tambourines whenever you hear Alleluia, Christ is risen. And the response is, He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Ring your bells. So listen, and whenever you hear it, we want a great din to celebrate the resurrection. Shall we just practice? Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. You've got it, you've got it. We're going to get underway shortly. I want us to imagine being in a garden early in the morning and coming across what you can see just in front of you. And this is the sight that greets you. A dark, cold, stone-like. And you might wonder what's behind. And so if there's any kids who would like to come and help to reveal to everybody what's behind here, why don't you come up to the front if you'd like to? And Grace and Rosa will help and show you what to do. Okay. our first hymn this morning, number 267. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia, number 267. So, in the light of Christ's resurrection, we hold before him the shortcomings of our own lives, our sins, and the brokenness of the world. We sit or kneel to pray. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins and confess to you our weakness and unbelief. We have lived by our own strength and not by the power of your resurrection. We have lived by the light of our own eyes as faithless and not believing. We have lived for this world alone and doubted our home in heaven. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. And so may the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. We're going to stand and sing now the words on your sheet. As a forgiven people of God, we sing God's glory.
Thank you.
As we stand, let us pray. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise and honour, glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen. Please do take your seats. And just before we hear our first reading, I wonder if someone can tell me what this is. It's not a trick question. It's an egg. It's an egg. I wonder from where you are if you can tell what sort of an egg it is. A brown egg. Thank you, Mike. It is a brown egg. I suspect a hen's egg. What I was wondering is it a raw egg, or a soft-boiled egg, or a hard-boiled egg? Any ideas? Any hard-boiled, do you think? Mm. If it's hard-boiled, it probably won't matter if I... Ooh. Oh, no! Oh! Oh, I think Philadelphia, it's gone under your feet. Things are not always what they seem, especially at Easter. It's a rubber brown hen's egg, not boiled or fried, but rubber. Things are not always as they seem. I wonder if you can spot any other eggs around the place. There are some in the place where we celebrate new life, and there are some where we hear the word of life. If anybody wants to run and see if they can find one, now would be the time as Joe comes to read our first reading. Oh, well done, well done. There's quite a few at the back, by the way. Oh, look. Well done, that eagle's sitting on one. Thank you.
Are we done?
I think so. Thank you, Jane.
The reading is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 10, verses 34 to 43. Then Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he set about doing good and healing all, and all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that anyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of God.
We're going to stand and sing again now. This will be a good one to join in with your instruments if you want to. We're going to sing Lord of the Dance, number 228 in your hymn books.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. We remain standing for our gospel reading.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb.
So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet, they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'"
Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her.
This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Let's pray as we stand. Lord Jesus, help us to look for you, to see you, to believe in you. Amen. Please do sit down. John's Gospel, which we just heard a passage read from, John's Gospel is all about looking and seeing. And looking and seeing may not turn out to be exactly the same thing. As we discovered with our eggs, what we look at, what we notice, may not be all that there is to see. So I wonder, as this scene was being set earlier on at the start of the service, what you noticed, maybe some of the details that were then picked up in that reading. What items or what things did you notice as the scene was revealed? Angels, thank you. We heard that in the reading, didn't we? Two angels in white were standing either side of the tomb. Anything else that anybody noticed? What did you notice? What did you find when you rolled back the stone? A white cloth. one long white cloth that might have been wrapped around a person. Did we notice anything else? Flowers, yes. We're in a garden. Thank you. I don't know if you could see very well, but there was also a smaller white cloth, a square one, perfectly folded. You might wonder why we do that at communion every week, have a perfectly folded white cloth. We read in the Bible that there was the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head, separate from the long winding cloth, folded neatly and placed separately to one side. I think that's probably most of the things we noticed, unless anybody had anything else they wanted to offer. When the disciples got to the tomb, to the garden, on that first Easter morning, the two chaps who were running ahead saw all of this. They noticed all of these things, and it says that Simon Peter saw and believed, just like that. But Mary Magdalene was looking, but it took her a while to see. And I wonder if you and I are more like Mary Magdalene than we are like the two disciples who got there first. We notice a lot of things with our own eyes, but to see with the eyes of faith can be quite a challenge, can't it? And it can be a long journey, maybe a lifetime's journey. Mary Magdalene was looking into the tomb, and she saw, perfectly reasonably, an empty tomb, the grave clothes left there, no body, just a dull, dark, cold cave. And I think we can forgive her for thinking the worst, for thinking, what on earth has happened here? It took Jesus to come and to call her by name, for her to see with the eyes of faith what was really going on here. To see that this wasn't a robbery. It wasn't that someone had done away with the body and put it somewhere else. It wasn't just all something they'd made up, a terrible dream. When Jesus spoke her name, she saw with the eyes of faith exactly what had happened, that he was risen. We look at the world, don't we, with physical eyes. And on this Easter Sunday, we look around the world, we look in our communities, and there is much that we notice with our eyes, which is hard to bear. But the message of Easter is that what we see with our physical eyes may not be all that there is to see. When we see the world through the eyes of faith, it doesn't take away the horror of the situations that we're observing. Mary Magdalene had still had that experience of standing at the foot of the cross and all that had happened just in the preceding days. But with the eyes of faith, she receives hope. And it's hope that allows us to look at a broken world and not to despair, but to take that hope and to use it in our own lives, in the world, to make a difference. Faith grounded in hope can change the world. And it's hope not in a vain sense, or I hope it might be sunny tomorrow, but hope that speaks our name, hope that calls us one by one, a sure and certain hope in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, a moment that changed history and continues to transform the world through those who see and believe. Amen. Can I invite you to stand as we affirm our faith in Jesus Christ, as we look and see and believe? And so I ask, do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? I believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. If you'd like to sit down, Francesca is going to lead us in our prayers for the world.
Let us pray. Father, as the impact of the economic situation around the world and in our country becomes increasingly stark, with the cost of living rising acutely, we pray for all those who are struggling to buy food, to pay bills, to provide for their loved ones, thinking particularly of families during the Easter holidays who rely on free school meals. Thank you for the work of food banks and other similar charities, thinking especially of the Sisters of the Church in St. Paul's. And pray for increased generosity by us all to support their work, whether financially or as volunteers. We pray for the work of many charities working with people living on our streets and on society's margins, with the likelihood of the numbers rising sharply as people fall increasingly into debt. We pray for wisdom, resourcefulness, and boldness for all leaders who have the potential to reduce the impact of poverty, and pray particularly for assistance to reach those in most desperate need. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we continue to bring before you the desperate situation in Ukraine. Recently, we have been horrified by the reports of the inhumane situations and unimaginable atrocities faced by so many civilians, and simply pray for an immediate cessation of such treatment, for the respect of human rights, and that civilians will be allowed to leave areas of conflict. And this morning, we particularly think of the situation in Mariupol and pray against further bloodshed. And we pray for all refugees from many different countries for their physical and mental health as they wait in limbo for a permanent sanctuary, adjust to a new way of life, or maybe find themselves after many months still in impossible situations, not knowing which way to turn. We thank you for the response of so many communities actively involved or hoping to be involved in hosting and supporting Ukrainian refugees. And as we pray for a simplification of the processing procedures that are delaying onward travel, we pray the same for refugees from Afghanistan and other countries who may be feeling rather neglected and wondering why they seem to be being treated differently. And over this Easter time, as our eyes have been turned towards Jerusalem, a city of such significance for Christians, Jews, and Muslims, we pray for a reduction in the tension between these different faith communities there and opportunities for discussions and a commitment to peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the witness of the church around the world. We pray for church leaders, for wisdom and boldness as to when to speak out against injustice, and for guidance as to the right words to say. May the church proclaim clearly the good news, he is risen. We thank you for our benefice, for James and all who work so hard, often behind the scenes, to ensure the smooth running of events and services. And we remember our church schools currently on holiday and pray for rest and refreshment for all staff and good family times for children. And we particularly pray for any children living with challenging situations at home, for whom home is not a happy place. We pray for all who are unwell or recovering from illness, and for all who are going through major changes and new challenges, thinking particularly of those we know in our benefice. And on this Easter Sunday, as we rejoice in the glory of our risen Lord and of all the saints who have shared his triumph over the grave and death, we pray for all who grieve, that they may be comforted by the certainty of eternal life for them and their much-missed loved ones. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Risen Lord, as you appeared to Mary in the garden, to the disciples in the upper room, to the travelers on the road to Emmaus, be known among us. May we be aware of your presence in all aspects of our lives, in our homes, in our work, in our relationships, and in our journeying. Risen Lord, let us walk in your presence and peace. May we and the whole church rejoice in your victory and proclaim the good news that death is defeated, that we are set free and Christ has won for us the victory. May we reflect the glory and the power of your resurrection and show the light of the world to those who are still walking in darkness. Let us not forget that we are an Easter people and Alleluia is our song. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, accept these our prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Would you please stand as we share the peace together? The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. So as we prepare to gather around the table for our communion, we're going to sing our offertory hymn. So during this hymn, a collection will be taken for the work of the church in this community. If you're able to give something, that will be appreciated. If that's not for you today, please just pass the bags along. And should you have neglected to bring any cash with you, which is often the way in these pandemic days, we now have a contactless giving device by the door, so fear not, you could give your offering on the way out at the end if you prefer. We're going to sing together number 500, There Is a Redeemer. Thank you. Heavenly Father, all things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Take these gifts and use them in your service, we pray. Amen. From page 6. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord is here. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Almighty God, good Father to us all, your face is turned towards your world. In love you gave us Jesus, your Son, to rescue us from sin and death. Your word goes out to call us home, to the city where angels sing your praise. We join with them in heaven's song. Father of all, we give you thanks for every gift that comes from heaven. To the darkness, Jesus came as your light. With signs of faith and words of hope, he touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean. This is his story. This is our song, Hosanna in the highest. The crowds came out to see your Son, yet at the end they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people. This is his story. This is our song, Hosanna in the highest. Jesus blessed you, Father, for the food. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body, given for you all." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, gave it, and said, "This is my blood shed for you all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." This is our story. This is our song, Hosanna in the highest. Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which he died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again and is alive with you to plead for us and all the world. This is our story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest. Send your spirit on us now, that by these gifts we may feed on Christ with opened eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, where all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. From page 12, as our Savior taught us, we sit or kneel and pray. Please pray our Lord's Prayer in whichever language comes first to you. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. We say together, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. And so draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. from page 14, we pray together. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. So as we prepare to bring our service to a close, I need to tell you that the Easter Bunny has been busy. The Easter Bunny has been busy around here. There are Easter biscuits and refreshments after the service. If you're able to stay, it would be lovely to talk with you and enjoy refreshments. There are also eggs hanging in trees that I noticed around the churchyard. Decorated paper eggs. So if anybody wants to go and look for those, and I do have to say, if you're going to go and run around the churchyard, you need someone, a grown-up, with you to make sure you don't have an accident or fall down a rabbit hole or something. So you can go out into the churchyard. If you find an egg, you can take it out of the tree and bring it back to me, and you might be able to exchange it for something a bit more exciting than a paper egg. So, refreshments inside, eggs outside. Enjoy the rest of your Easter Sunday. Let's stand and sing together our final hymn of Christ's victory. Thine be the glory, number 503. God the Father, by whose glory Christ was raised from the dead, strengthen you to walk with him in his risen life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and those for whom you pray. Remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.